good, Sam. Well, it's so great to have you.
It's wonderful to be here. I'm so excited.
Congratulations on all your success. By the way, you walked out to your version of Lady Gaga's Applause. And I'm curious, how do you pick the songs you're going to cover, and why in particular did you want to do that one?
Well, I'm always on the lookout for new pop songs that when I hear them, I can imagine a version that I could do that would bring something new and creative to it. And Lady Gaga's stuff is already so kind of interesting and creative that I figured Lady Gaga's always a good challenge to make it your own. But I had a great time with that video.
Well, let's talk about how this all got started, Sam, because you're studying classical Greek at Yale, right? You graduated
yes.
in 2009, is that right?
2011.
2011. Yep. Did you know my daughter Ellie, by the way?
We were off by 1 year, yeah.
Oh, well, that's so funny. Anyway.
Small world.
So you were studying classical Greek at Yale, and then suddenly you start doing stuff for YouTube. How did it all happen?
Yeah, well, at the time that I started putting videos up, the landscape of YouTube was totally different. You know, there weren't as many people building these big careers on the site yet. And so when I first started putting up videos, I just sort of joined with a buddy of mine, Kurt Schneider, who's a great producer, and we said, you know, let's just do something for fun and put these videos up. Maybe people will watch them, maybe they won't. And so we just started doing it as a total hobby, no idea that anything would come of it. And we posted that Michael Jackson medley, and that was the first time, you know, at every stage we were excited that anyone beyond our family and friends were watching our videos, but that was the first time. Wow,
well, it was so clever too, because it was you obviously doing all the different harmonies for a bunch of different
yeah.
Michael Jackson songs, great songs. And when the video started to go viral and you got all these hits, what did you think? Were you amazed?
Oh, absolutely. You know, we were excited when we put out the first video and it got 500 views. That was exciting for us because at the time we had no sense of scale. So when that Michael Jackson medley was the first to hit 1 million and then the first to hit 10 million, and it just becomes hard to even wrap your head around that kind of number and imagine that those are people sitting in front of computers or on phones watching this music that we had put our heart and soul into making, which was so cool.
You grew up in Philadelphia, and I know you're sort of a High School Musical kid, right?
Of course.
Typical chorus guy. You loved musicals. But then you got to Yale where a cappella is so huge. I think it's really big at a lot of colleges
yeah.
and universities these days. But what do you think of that trend? Because it's been around for a while, but it seems, I guess thanks to movies like Pitch Perfect
sure.
and other things, it seems bigger than ever.
Yeah, you know, I think it's refreshing that a cappella is so musical. It's to do it well, it's really difficult because you've got just, you have to arrange it, you really have to rehearse a lot, and it's about the voices, stripping music down to, vocal music down to its most basic components. So I think that really speaks to people, and that's exciting, and especially the fact that it's become such a collegiate staple. People just love that energy and that attention to real musicality that is important for
them. Well, I think it's so exciting to hear people sing and use their voices as instruments, right?
It's so cool.
To do it without any
yeah.
kind of accompaniment. I love it. And I know that you were at one point, after you got to be a big sensation on YouTube, you were offered a record deal, but you turned it down. How come?
You know, the landscape of the music industry is changing constantly now with all of these new ways of consuming music. And so, you know, I had built up this fan base leaving college, and I really wanted my first album to be totally on my own terms, to have full artistic control. And a lot of times with traditional record deals, you don't get that, certainly with your first album. There's a lot that goes into that process. And so with independent musicians like me who have been lucky enough to build up this means of distribution, namely my YouTube channel, all my social media, it felt like it made sense for my first album to be done on my own terms, for my fans, and I'm really happy that I did that.
Well, you know, Kevin Alacker is the head of culture and trends at YouTube, and he's here today. And Kevin, why do you think Sam has been such a phenomenal success on YouTube?
Yeah, well, I mean, I think to build up that distribution that he was just talking about, he has this very strong connection with his fans. And that's what a lot of people like Sam have been able to do, is build these big audiences of people who may see that one video and then subscribe or follow his account on YouTube so they'll see everything else that he posts. And he's part of this whole new crop of artists that have emerged on YouTube and collaborate with each other and appear in each other's videos. I mean, some of the videos that Sam's appeared in have hundreds of millions of views if you add them all together. Across all these different channels that he's appeared on.
And how does somebody like Sam make a living off YouTube? I mean, you guys have a unique partnership arrangement, don't
yeah.
you? Where he's able to, I guess, enjoy the sponsors that maybe come his way with all those eyeballs.
Yeah, I mean, there's advertising. He can sell his albums now that he's with the audience that he's built on YouTube. He can go on tour. There's all these possibilities now.
And I know that today you're going to perform a song that you wrote recently, an original song. Tell us a little bit about it.
Well, yeah, I'm working, constantly writing for my second album, and this is one I just wrote last week, and I thought it'd be fun to do. It's called Clumsy. It's about how when we fall in love, we all tend to get a little clumsy with our hearts.